Suddenly, we heard a siren, and we figured it was time to get out of here.
Come on.
But what was I supposed to do with all these sick people and no one to help them? I mean, here we were, stuck in some godforsaken third world country, and communist no less. When I was a kid, these people wanted to kill us. What was I supposed to do?
I'm on the way to Cuba, where all is happy.
Yes, sir.
Cuba, where all is gay. Why don't you plan a wonderful trip to Havana?
Excuse me. We're looking for a doctor. Is there a doctor here in Cuba?
Any doctor?
Bueno, en la esquina hay un doctor particular. Aquí está el hospital. Aquí está la farmacia.
All in this one block?
Todo, sí. Normalmente en la mayoría de las cuadras es así, farmacia, hay un hospital cerca.
All right, thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay, I know what you're thinking. Cuba is where Lucifer lives. The worst place on earth. The most evil nation ever created. How do we know that? Because that's what we've been told for over 45 years.
That a series of offensive missile sites can be none other than to provide a nuclear strike capability against the Western Hemisphere.
I'm not going to yield until Fidel Castro allows freedom on the island. That's it. See? You can count on it. Put it in the bank.
It seems that what really bugged us about Castro was that he overthrew the dictator that we liked and replaced him with a guy we didn't like, himself. And so now, after all these years, one thing is clear. The Cuban people have free, universal health care. They become known around the world as having not only one of the best healthcare systems, but as being one of the most generous countries in providing doctors and medical equipment to third world countries. In the U.S., healthcare costs run nearly $7,000 per person. But in Cuba, they spend only $251. And yet, the Cubans are able to have a lower infant mortality rate than the United States, a longer average lifespan than the United States. They believe in preventive medicine, and it seems like there's a doctor on every block. Their only sin when it comes to health care seems to be that they don't do it for a profit.
Anybody need medication right now for the pharmacy?
Why don't you leave your cares and troubles behind? And why, nevertheless, I'm glad to see you.
Well,
in CU.
Are you the pharmacist? Do you have this?
Is this one similar to yours? Or?
Yeah. It's $120 in the U.S.
This is $120 in the U.S?
Yes.
¿Cuánto cuesta ese?
$320. So how much is that in American dollars?
It's like
5 cents.
5 cents?
Yeah, more or less.
Hay una doctora. Te voy a dar el nombre. Y dile que le haga.
And the doctor will give me a
prescription. Dos recetas, aunque sea, entiende por qué.
Sí. Voy al médico.
Sí, ve ahí.
Thank you very much. Muchas gracias.
$120 is a lot of money when you're getting $1,000 in Social Security disability and you need one or two a month. 5 cents here, it's like the biggest insult. It just doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense. I want to fill a suitcase up and go back home with it.
I took my group of sick Americans to a hospital to see if they could get some care. They didn't ask for money or an insurance card.
Regina Cervantes.
Just their name and date of birth.
Febrero 22.
That was the entire intake session.
Nos sentimos muy agradecidos de recibirlos hoy en el día de hoy. Y al igual que hacemos con todos los pacientes, brindaremos una atención médica de la más alta calidad. si logramos que se sientan bien atendidos y que mejore su problema de salud, realmente cumpliremos con nuestro objetivo.
Thank you very much for doing this.
I asked them to give us the same exact care they give their fellow Cuban citizens. No more, no less. And that's what they did.
I'm Dr. Broke. I'm an internal medicine specialist.
John Graham.
How are you feeling?
My lungs hurt. I have pain. I get pretty severe nosebleeds at times.
I get terrible headaches in the middle of the night, but I haven't been evaluated for the sleep apnea for 9 years.
Yeah, I have
many medications for lung problems.
Almost every medication for lung problems.
After 9/11, since some things that have happened, my teeth started falling out. Because of certain conditions, I was grinding.
This one test that they recommended I take, it's about $5,000 to $7,000.
The dentist that I talked to, it's like $15,000 or more.
Now it's 2 years. I have no medical coverage, so I can't go for the last part of the test.
No se preocupe, que todo eso va a ser estudiado.
It's okay. Everything's gonna be okay, right?
Yes. I am. It's so hard for me to digest somebody saying it's free. Because 20 years of our lives have been spent fighting. So I am so grateful.
No, you don't need to say that. Okay?
Thank you.
Okay. Come on, don't cry. Everything's gonna be okay, right?
Thank you.
At least what we can do, right?
Es una pequeña islita del Caribe con muy pocos recursos. Se puede hacer mucho por la salud del ser humano y eso no ocurre en Estados Unidos de Norteamérica. ¿Por qué nosotros podemos y ustedes no? Ahí sí tendríamos que darnos cuenta, porque un país, mientras más produce, mientras más riquezas tiene, puede cuidar mejor a su gente.
Reggie was diagnosed with a series of pulmonary and bronchial problems. The Cuban doctors gave her a treatment plan to follow back home, along with some of those 5-cent inhalers. William Marr received a number of treatments on his neck and his back, and having ground down his teeth for 3 years straight due to post-traumatic stress disorder, he left Cuba with a new set of teeth. After a series of tests on his heart, lungs, blood, and stomach, John now knew what his ailments were. He was given a strict plan to follow, plus a number of treatments, and was feeling better than he had in years. The Cuban doctors were able to take Donna off 5 of her 9 medications, and with the correct diagnosis, gave her a treatment plan to help her live a more normal life. When the firefighters and paramedics in Havana heard that the 9/11 rescue workers were in town, they invited them over to one of their firehouses. And so on our last day there, as we arrived, they stood at attention because, they said, they wanted to honor the heroes of 9/11.
Un gran honor que hayan decidido visitar mi estación de bomberos, como le llaman ustedes. Conocí de los sucesos del 11 de septiembre. Nos causó una impresión muy triste a nosotros. Desde el punto de vista humano, hubiéramos querido estar allí para poder cooperar con